Tell me we haven't done this, though.
Pero no hay boda.
Tengo muchas novias. Y no hay boda.
If you go back to episode one of the Little Brown Boys, this is what it sounds like.
Bro, shout out to these fools, bro. I don't know who they are. I don't know how I came across this clip, fool. But I've watched this like 1,000 fucking times. Yeah.
And I'm sure you have.
And then just to
this ain't funny. Mentor Mas 47 said this ain't funny 2 days ago.
Bro. And there's a lot of people out here that think that what's funny is not funny, big dog. And let me tell you right now, these fools are funny as fools. Come to show that they're comedians.
Right.
Both of those fools.
Yeah.
And the funny thing is that I am like one fall away from being the fool with the glasses.
Yeah. One more street fight.
One more street fight.
Here, right there.
One fool's blind, by the way.
Okay.
The fool with the red jacket.
Yeah.
That fool's blind.
So music is his life.
Yeah, bro. And then I went through the comments like you were just saying right now, and it's like so many people trying to put in their 2 cents. Fool, these fools have a Netflix show together.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
It looks like they're having fun.
They're on set.
Oh, okay.
They're on set. Okay. And then they're just like behind the scenes type.
Okay. You know what I mean? Yeah, it literally looks like they're having fun. Like a whole lot of fun. But you can't be mad at that.
Yeah, you who are you to tell these fools like, hey, that's not funny.
Yeah.
What exactly? Bro?
Exactly. Yeah, like I guess we're not are we laughing at them?
Nah, bro.
I'm not laughing with them.
I'm laughing with them, bro.
Okay. Cuz they know it's funny too, right? They're entertaining.
Better night, brother.
Yeah, that's funny, bro. That's funny. I'm sorry.
No, then he goes, "Veo chameo, pero no jala."
You memorized the whole thing like a fucking script. Are you going to audition or what?
Bro, that's my new Halloween costume right there.
Hell yeah. You almost have it on right now. You almost have the costume on right now.
But turns out that these fools have a show on Netflix, dog.
Okay.
And it's called OJITOS DE HUEVO. And they're like, these two, there's a big comedy scene in Mexico.
Yeah.
A huge. I mean,
okay. It grew in the last two, three years.
Yeah, they like podcasting in Mexico went crazy. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But it's like it's kind of cool in a way because not only did these fools do stand up comedy, they started podcasting, and then from there they got their show.
Right.
So the Netflix show is called OJITOS DE HUEVO, and it's just it just talks about their upbringing, like how they grew up being blind and being crippled.
Right.
And growing up in Mexico.
Getting bullied as fuck.
Because as it is, fool, Mexico is like, it is a tough spot.
Yeah.
It's not woke. It's not woke, bro.
Yeah. So,
you get what I'm saying?
Definitely.
And then like,
other people that are getting mad in the comments were born and raised here.
Yeah. Just take some time from the show. Like, subscribe, follow, tell your homies about it. Tell your mama, tell your teachers. If you like what we bring to the table, you already know what we do. Leave a comment, like, subscribe, follow the show on all social media, and let's get back to the show.
I went into a rabbit hole and went into, like, the show and all that shit, fool. Did you watch the show?
Yeah. It's fucking hilarious, fool.
It's in Spanish?
In Spanish, yeah.
Subtitles on or off?
Oh, off, bro.
Off?
Off.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't like, get out of my way.
Oh, yeah?
Get out of my way.
But you get it then.
Yeah. Like,
all right.
Sometimes
I doubt it.
No, yes. Some things I gotta be like, what?
What? Yeah.
But
bro, trust. The subtitles, they come in handy. Yeah. Well, I don't know. Maybe because I'm like I like words.
Yeah.
Like sometimes I'm like, oh, I didn't know that's what that meant.
I get furious at subtitles, bro.
Especially in Spanish. Like I'll be like, oh, that's what that's called.
You know how many times I've seen John Wick with subtitles? With my dad?
A lot, bro. Oh, okay.
Yeah. He's a subtitle. He's the fool that changes the computer language to in Spanish, bro, and I don't even know what the
buzón.
What is fuck?
That's
button to me.
Yeah.
You know, definitely. I can't do that.
Yeah, like when my dad asks me for help on his phone.
Sistema preferencias configuraciones ajustar.
Yeah.
What the fuck, bro?
Yeah.
I don't change my shit, bro.
Resolución.
Yeah, resolución.
I don't know.
Fucking calibrar sistema preferido.
Yeah,
I'm telling you these words because I've been through there, bro. Yeah,
that's why I watch in subtitles.
Yeah, nah.
Because I need to know a little bit.
Yeah, fool. Like,
even in English, I'll put subtitles. Yeah, because there's words in English that I'm like, oh, okay, that's the context clues. I know what that means. You know what I mean?
You know, who, what, where, how it went?
Yeah, like, what is that word? But I'm like, okay, they're talking about this in that all situation. Right. What's the setting? All right, that's the setting for sure. Shit. Who's the protagonist?
Where's the climax? Right, yeah, now? Where's climax? I'm trying to figure this out.
Yeah,
fuck I feel you, though. But, yeah, dog, I think right now I'm a more of a... of a comedy, Mexico's comedy snub.
I get you.
Mexican comedy to me, rifa over this bullshit we got over here.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Because like you just said, fool, it's not woke. I'm so not woke. I'm asleep right now. I'm sleepwalking mm-hmm, right now. Mm-hmm. Like I'm not down with a lot of things in this fucking shit.
Situation.
You know, situation. Sistema preferido.
Yeah.
My shit's all fucked
up. You gotta calibrar real
quick. Yeah. I gotta change my settings. Imagine being crippled, bro, and growing up and like, and then becoming out of so much bullying, bro. You're like, fuck it, it's on. I'm gonna become a comedian.
Yeah. When you are crippled or differently abled, it's hard to find the avenue, right? Because what are you gonna? You can't be really a construction worker.
Yeah.
You can't really if you got you like palsy or something. You can't work with your hands.
You can't be a chef. That's for goddamn.
You know
sure.
what I mean? You feel me? So it's like there's very little things for you to do other than be on disability forever. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's to break out of your box, you got to find something. And entertainment is a good one. Yeah. You know, like if you look at like Kill Tony, for example. Kill Tony has like this group of comedians that are regulars or golden ticket winners or whatever. Yeah, yeah, yeah. 80 to 90% are, they got something.
A disability. One foot can't stop shaking.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, to me, it's like an example that some of the funniest people have something not necessarily wrong with them, but something different to them.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because you tell these people, oh, there's something wrong with you. Oh, you can't see something wrong with you. But that's fucked up, dog.
Yeah.
You just got to be like, hey, there's something different about you, bro.
Yeah.
You can't see. That's different. But that doesn't mean, I mean, I could see.
Damn, you're trying to win the fucking, the Emmy right now?
Hey, we're woke over here,
dog. You're trying to get woke right now?
We're woke, G.
Nah, I feel you, though.
Put me on the show.
Yeah, I feel you, though. No, I'm just retarded.
No, but people that have something different about them would love it if they got treated the same as others.
Yeah.
You know, just because somebody has something different about them, you can't, I mean, you should kind of help them out, but don't. Treat them totally fucking different.
It's a difference between being sympathetic and empathetic or whatever.
I have no idea about that.
No,
but I'll take your word for it.
Sistema configuraciones preferidas, compa.
Yeah. Unless you're not being hurt. I mean, because, all right, I get it. You can't be laughing at people with disabilities, as they say. Different abilities, right? But if they're entertaining and trying to be funny, fucking chuckle.
More power to them, if anything.
Exactly.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
Go for it.
They're being vulnerable.
Exactly.
They're not
usually like when you get nicknames, it's because of your fucking defects.
Okay.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like El Pirata.
Right.
You know why? Because he's fucking missing an eye.
There was another full name, Cantaro.
Why?
Because he was shaped like one.
Oh.
I knew that one for sure, because as soon as I see him at all, I get it.
But you can't do that
But they would just call him Canta.
Damn, you can't do that.
For short.
You can't do that here, fool.
You can't. Just nickname people just for their fucking disabilities?
Two-step. And he's like, the homie two-step.
Yeah, that's.
He has a limp.
Remember? Shout out Hyper, bro.
Oh.
Remember Hyper, bro?
Hyper, God.
That's the guy, man. That's the man. I hope he's doing great.
Oh, man. Hyper, bro. Yeah, growing up, we had some fire nicknames for fools.
We did. Lunch B.
Lunch B, yo.
There was a fool named Lunch B.
Lunch B. Because he would ditch to kick it. Oh, my God. He would, because it was Lunch A and Lunch B, right? Yeah, two different periods. Yeah. But we would all hang.
He embodied, like, what Lunch B meant. You know what I mean? That's crazy that we would do that.
Yeah,
but I think, like you were saying, I think bullying will either, it'll bring two things out of you, bro. It'll make you like a fighter or a comedian. Because I didn't have a disability growing up, fool, but in high school, I had a lot of acne on my face, you know? Yeah. So I felt kind of
vulnerable.
Insecure.
Yeah.
And like the only thing, one of the only things that can make me confident about myself is like getting laughs out of people.
Of course.
Or knowing how to back my shit up in the cipher of fucking comedians.
Yeah, because it was like, it was a fucking
Yeah.
Yeah, it was
brutal. You either get bullied and go into a hole, or you fucking like, yeah, but you.
You too, motherfucker.
Yeah, then you hit them with a good one. Yeah. So it's like, I get it. Bad bullying is bad, but if used correctly,
yeah,
you could use it to formulate fucking some concoctions. Fucking,
yeah, food, like you can win the battle by accepting.
There you go.
Your fucking flaws.
There you go. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It what doesn't kill you make you stronger. Exactly. Type shit.
Damn. Type bro. B. Are we? You know what? Food? We're becoming wise men. Huh?
Wise fucking man.
We're like not little brown boys no more, bro. Little brown. Wise boys.
Okay, if you say so.
Talking about being woke and Mexico, gentrification is happening machine over there. Mm-hmm. Imagine that, fool. Like you're so used to like going to the tortilla spot, going to the carnicero, mm-hmm,
and or you don't always eat chicharrón.
Yeah,
but you know where to get it.
That, and then now you go back one morning. You go back. It's closed, and it's an Erewhon.
Yeah.
It's a fucking Erewhon on Calle 10 y Cuauhtémoc.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What the fuck, bro? Yeah. When the fuck did this happen?
Yeah.
That OXXO is not, OXXO is still like a poverty store, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. In my eyes. Over there.
It's like a more gangster 7-Eleven.
Yeah, yeah, way more gangster. Yeah. The workers fuck you up.
Yeah. They got a little window at the door. Yeah. You know what I mean? Because if it's too late, you could still buy a bottle, but you got to put it through a little window.
You know what I mean? Put it sideways.
Yeah. They're like, ¿qué quieres? Una de reposado. Yeah. And some cigarros. Okay.
All right. It's a combo little baggie already.
Yeah.
But yeah, food, like gentrification in Mexico, it kind of like, I never thought it would happen.
But you know why?
Why?
I don't know why, but I could speculate.
What?
So there's a lot of jobs in Mexico, like, for example,
IT.
There's a lot of shit happening because not only are the U.S. Americans going, but the Chinese and people like that are going to mine minerals. Like, there's a lot of lithium coming out. And there's a lot of, there's starting to be a lot more manufacturing going on there.
Yeah.
And they're saying that, all right, so. You could either send your manufacturing to China or you could send it to Mexico. Yeah, if you're in the U.S., right? They say that the Mexicans are smarter and work harder for cheaper than the Chinese do. The Chinese are a little bit dumber and they charge a little bit more.
And you got to wait 3 months because you got to
fucking... And handling.
You're shipping and handling, big dog.
Yeah.
You got to wait 3 months because it's on the boat.
Yeah. So like in China... Since they have so many people and so many big jobs, all the jobs there are like push and go, or like they're very like this. There's not a lot of thinking going on. They're just, we need people to sew this line. Right. And you're right there sewing the same line for years.
Yeah.
So the people don't generate skills doing those kind of jobs. In Mexico, they have more jobs where like you got to figure shit out and use your brain. There's a lot more math and shit going on in the jobs in Mexico. So. The fools in Mexico putting it down for labor, like cheaper labor, have a little bit more of a skill. So what's next after jobs go there? The motherfucking manager, supervisor guy that's from
fucking
New Mexico is fucking down there fucking trying to bring the fucking Krispy Kreme.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He needs his Krispy Kreme, dog. Friday.
Yo, ain't that the motherfucking truth, huh? Yeah,
so now fucking the chicharrón spot that Doña Maria has been having forever now has to sell the chicharrón, but it's in package. It's in a bag already. Like, it has a fucking a label on it.
Yeah.
It's not like
more commercialized.
You back then, you would order 10 pesos de chicharrones I got. And she'll grab it with her hand, and she'll put it in a bag. And turn it around, knot it, and then give it to you.
Yeah.
Now,
without weighing it, but hey, weigh it. I got and it's you. The
I
weight.
I already know. Yeah. I already know the weight right here. I already know. Hey, but now the fucking chicharrón is coming back.
You know what's gonna suck? You know what's gonna suck, fool? Health inspectors are gonna come in and make them clean the cazuelas that haven't been clean for years. That have the seasoning, bro.
Yeah.
You know how many fucking grandmas worked on this cazuela, and now because you want a grade A, we gotta steam everything.
Yeah.
And I gotta wear a uniform.
Yeah. I don't know where or when, but I heard there was this place, like this diner, that had this big deep fryer where they would fry their fries, But that deep fryer still had oil from like the 1980s.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I know what you're talking about. There's some Asian
food. You know, it's not completely all oil from 1980, but there's a little bit of residue. Yeah. You know what I mean? Sometimes you got to risk it for the little bit of residue.
Like, gentrification comes in a lot of ways. It's not only, like, the prices, bro. Like, but the history, too, fool. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're saying that lady, she got it on lock, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's so many other things that come into, like, play. Like, trees, bro. Oh, that's the tree that I fucking, you know, I finger your mom.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Finger
yeah,
your
yeah.
mom on that tree. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now it's a fucking flower garden with a fucking mural of...
Nipsey Hussle. Not funny, dog. But you get what I'm saying.
It's a fucking mural of Nipsey Hussle in fucking Cuauhtémoc and Calle 10.
Chiapas.
Chiapas.
Hey.
Hey, the marathon continues.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, dog? Come on, fool. Yeah, we got fool. $30 beanies.
That's a little bit. That too, fool, like, clothes, dog. También, like,
you know it's gentrified? When they got a mural of the Wings.
Oh, yeah.
And you
yeah.
can stand in front and take a picture.
Photo op spots.
You know what I mean? Photo op spots. That's yeah. when you know.
Get the fuck
or
out of
one
here.
Big ass wall painted pink. Like hot pink.
I'd be so hot if I was a local, dog. I'd
the
be
first
hot.
Signs of gentrification.
Oh, man. I'll be pocket checking Smiths and Hendersons.
Smiths
and Hendersons and Jovics or yeah. whatever the fuck yeah. their last names are.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You got to have two menu prices.
Oh, two menu prices is a smart way to do it.
Some for the regulars. Yeah. You know them already. And then another menu price
I'm
for
pretty,
the people
I'm
that
positive
are,
that's going down.
Of course.
Yeah, fool.
I mean, it's happened to me. When I go to Mexico, they look at me and they're like, all right, you're paying double, G.
Yeah, for sure.
And I'm like, don't even trip. I will. I wonder if the narcos are taxing them extra, though. Because that's something in Mexico that we don't have in the U.S.
Oh, yeah, like, organized crime?
Yeah. The U.S. will tax you, right? Yeah. Like business tax and property tax and all that bullshit. But it's not at gunpoint.
Yeah, yeah,
like
yeah,
the narcos
yeah.
in Mexico, and you can't say no because they'll fucking kidnap you.
Yeah, bro, that's fucking wild.
So
bro.
I
just go missing
the
out
fucking
of
white mocha. What yeah, the white mocha missing. Coffee shop dog is paying extra.
Oh,
for
yeah.
sure, bro.
A Starbucks just delivering yellow envelopes.
Yeah, yeah, for Manila folders.
Yeah, bro. Let me get my fucking coffee, and you already know
and
what
you
it
already
is.
Know what I'm here for. Yeah,
yeah. yeah. And fucking sistema
hey, configurado. You're the cashier and you notice that all of a sudden there's nobody in the fucking store.
But there's two guys walking in?
Yeah, you're like, all right, hold the fuck up. Yeah. What's going on?
And now, like, the real estate, back then it was cuarto, sala, cocina, fucking restroom. Right. And roof for azotea.
Yeah, for the fucking
for the
water,
dogs.
For the water tank.
And the dogs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Now it's fucking underground pool.
Oh,
fucking!
Oh, I get you.
A concrete driveway mm-hmm. with a bunker.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, 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 yeah.
And a fucking top golf.
Yeah, a putting green. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah, like yeah. what the? And over there, I'm assuming they don't have like they have limited like restrictions on how to build your house. You yeah. can as long as you pay your fucking terreno, big dog.
Yeah,
that's you.
Good. You can build whatever.
Yeah,
you could have a toboggan.
Yeah. It's like, oh, this is how I get to my car. Yeah. Just a
Sick.
Slide.
Hell yeah.
A fucking toboggan from your bedroom to, you, what are you, Bruce Wayne?
Yeah, a toboggan from your bedroom to the cold plunge. To the cold plunge. You know, so you can fucking start your morning off, right? That's gentrification,
dog. Yo, the toboggan to the cold plunge?
Yeah. And the cold plunge is the fucking tinaco or whatever it's called. Where you wash your dishes.
The big
and where you wash your clothes at.
The fucking with the ridges?
Yeah, with the ridges. Yeah.
You yeah,
cold plunge for 3 minutes.
They don't want to see me with the pesos to make a house, fool, because I'll go crazy.
Yeah. Cold plunge and then you massage your back on the fucking on the lavadora part.
With the fucking
Yeah. Welcome to fucking
Chiapas, compa.
Chiapas, yeah. Are you retired, G?
Check this pad out.
This pad comes with a pool table. You know, like, what do people do when they retire?
Oh my god, bro.
What are other signs of gentrification? Like early signs of gentrification. Coffee shops for sure.
For sure. Pet grooming. Pet grooming is always a sign of gentrification. Like no.
Oh, you wash your dog?
Yeah, you get your dog
bro,
washed?
Bro, a pet groomer in Mexico would be crazy.
Yeah.
Imagine that. Pressure I'm sure washed. There is, right? I'm sure there is. Yeah, there is. Right? Of course. Of yeah, course yeah. There is.
But estética like, para perros.
That is crazy. Yeah. Because in Mexico, they treat dogs like animals. Like, yeah. They're animals.
Yeah. He is a dog.
Yeah.
Not a member of the family.
He's not man's best friend.
Yeah.
He's a perrito guagua. You know what I mean?
Ve dale los huesos del caldo de pollo al perro.
That's crazy. You know, I started watching these dog grooming videos.
Yeah.
On
a girl YouTube. With a dog?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's crazy.
That shit blew my mind.
Yeah. And this is Sophie. She's a 29-year-old fucking whatever, and she has a fucking ROI investment capital. Yeah, bro. Like, yeah, what,
yeah,
bitch?
Yeah.
If you don't throw that fucking little poodle in a fucking pressure washer right now.
It's a golden doodle, and she's in debt for fucking going to get her master's. But she's a fucking golden doodle with fucking fleas. Like, how much is the pet grooming? Oh, it's only... Oh,
she's a golden doodle trying to get her master's. Yeah. Oh, fuck,
bro. You gotta sign a paper when you drop them off.
Fool, they don't want to see us gentrifying that area, bro. I'll have a store just for toboganes, bro. Yeah,
that's a good-ass store. That's a good story.
I'll be like, yo, this toboggan has LEDs. Yeah. This one has TVs. Bluetooth. This one, it's like your warp speed.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be sick. It's not even to buy the toboggan. You could just ride them. You know what I mean? It's like, you know they have trampoline parks here?
Yeah, that's another sign of gentrification. You're going to take up space. A commercial size space.
To put to trampolines.
Jump.
Yeah.
To jump.
And foam pits. Yeah, that's crazy, man.
Yeah.
We could be slaughtering pigs right here.
Yeah.
But yeah, you want to fucking jump in foam pits.
This used to be a marqueta.
Yeah. That's crazy. Yeah, foam pits and trampolines.
Gentrification.
Next to a fucking...
Tobogan store.
Yeah, where you could ride the toboganes. That's lit, G. I would go. At least once. At least once. Like, oh, I'm here. I vine a traer los sobrinos.
That was really? A good question, bro. The fucking, what are signs of?
The first signs?
Yeah.
Parking. If they tear shit down to build like a 3-story parking, you know you're fucked.
Yeah, you're fucked.
Especially if they have the little number of open parking spots. You know, like, oh, there's 12.
Yeah, bro. Yeah. There's 12 available right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, hurry up to level 2. Well, there's 12. But on level 3, there's 120.
Yeah, I was going to say that. But you're too lazy to go to level 3.
Oh, we got to go down the stairs?
Yeah.
No, fuck
I'm
that.
I'm good. I'll just parallel park on the street.
Let's just park on red. Yeah. Let's just fucking park in front of a fire hydrant. Wait, we're just going to get the chicharrón and leave. We're not going to fucking shop around. What? Ooh, a bullshit jewelry store. Like where they just have like random...
Zales.
Yeah. Like not even jewelry. Like fucking like leather
woven.
Yeah.
Woven shit. Yeah.
Like a fucking leather bracelet.
Hemp pillows.
There you go.
Hemp pillows.
That bullshit.
That are fucking raspy. They're not even like comfortable, bro. They scratch you.
If it's called boutique.
Oh, you're Lord. Downey is fucked.
Oh, yeah.
Downey is fucked because there's so many boutiques que valen pito.
Yeah. There's a boutique that barely sells.
And it's still, that's the and headquarters. It's
like all white inside. It's all white inside. That's run.
Start to hit up run. The real estate agency.
Yeah. Put your fucking canicas away, dog, because we got to go.
Yeah.
Shit is going to be, they're going to start charging across the street.
And it's nuts, fool, because, like, there's people out there, dog, that they never even asked for this, you know? Like,
right,
they're so used to, some fools still listen to the radio out there.
Yeah, for sure.
You know what I mean?
For sure. Oh, and now, don't even have a radio.
Yeah, and now, like, you gotta go fucking, like, ¿qué es esta madre? Like,
yeah.
Can't even order food because you don't even know what it is.
Yeah, you can't order food because you don't know how to work a tablet.
Yeah.
There's a restaurant where you order off a tablet, you're completely fucked.
Imagine going to a tortilleria and you got to put the kilos that you want.
On a fucking touchscreen, fool, and then like, nothing wrong.
See, de maíz, de grano, or de that's too much.
That's too much, man.
I just want my little pink fucking paper roll.
I just want to give you what my mom gave me, like this, and you go like this. And then you give me the tortilla, and then I get on my bike and I leave. You know what I mean? I don't want to fuck up your tablet. Because I haven't cut my nails in like 3 weeks. How about we did it like we used to, you know?
A tortilleria with the tablet is crazy,
yeah, bro. I don't know about this 15% gratitude,
yeah,
little buddy.
Oh, damn. The doja hit yeah. you with the 360? Yeah,
ver, firmale. Oh, wait, she 360?
Yeah, she 360.
Firmale the... ahí. Like, damn. What?
See, I wouldn't be mad at that because that's them poniéndose las pilas. You know what I mean?
Right.
But I get furious at that, fool. That fucking tip, like, oh, sign here. And yeah. then they, you know what bugs me the fucking most, fool? Is that they do it, and some people walk away because they're ashamed.
Right.
They hit you with the, I'm gone. Yeah. This is you right here.
Yeah.
No, bitch.
You finish.
Watch me put no tip.
You know, I'll tip if they do something. If they're doing shit.
Yeah.
If I order online, I go pick it up. And then tip right there, I'm kind of like, ah, well,
what's going
on? What are we doing here? Yeah. If I show up to the restaurant, they ask me how you're doing, and like they take my order, I'm sitting there.
Oh, you want some extra sauces?
Extra sauces. Then yeah. we're tipping.
Yeah.
Also, if I get delivery, I'm tipping.
Yeah.
Because nobody wants to be delivering.
Yeah, it sucks.
You know what I mean? Like, especially it's the day after Thanksgiving, nobody wants to deliver two pizzas.
Yeah.
To a fool that
didn't even go to Thanksgiving.
It hasn't showered, you know? That's yeah. been playing Call of Duty for like
yeah, I get
5
you.
Hours.
I get you 100%. Yeah, but you got me fucked I'm up with that. Right with there. That 180. But fuck. Yeah, I wouldn't even be mad if a doña hit me with that shit and I'm buying medio kilo de tortillas and she hits me with the 180.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You're getting an extra $2.
Yeah. And you got those chanclas on.
Yeah. Know? Just chanclas.
You walked.
That's so funny, bro. Gentrified.
You
hood
took
spot.
Your own bag. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like the tortilla bag. Because you don't go just expecting tortillas. You gotta take a canasta. A canasta. Shit. Yeah, shit. Like a bag thing.
Yeah, fool.
Like my mom said, fill it up. Here. Here's the change. I'm trying to get back.
ASAP. Once you see like nutrition spots too, bro.
Right. Herbalife.
Know? Nah, I mean, people already know it caught on. People already caught on to the Herbalife scam. Yeah.
There's still people out there that believe. Yeah.
That believe.
I mean, it works if you work.
¿Quién quiere resultado?
Yeah, it works if you work. Let's be honest. Yeah. There's no magic pill to get fit.
Yeah.
But I mean, you could buy fucking regular protein.
Yeah, once you see fucking yoga studios.
Oh, yeah. That's the last. I think that's last.
That's the last. That's the cherry on top.
It's too late. Like, it's code red already. You know what I mean? Like when zombies come, it's like once the yoga studios pull up, it's like these are the tier 3 zombies.
Yeah, you know? Yeah, this is the monsters. Yeah, the big monsters.
There's a hive around here. There's an empresa right now around here. Somewhere.
Damn, bro. Yeah, once you start seeing foods or even hearing conversations, dog. Es que estoy haciendo una dieta. Yeah. Y ahorita no quiero, like, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, oh, ¿vas a querer comer? No, nomás vine a leer mi libro porque estoy haciendo una dieta de fucking...
I got one.
You know which one?
When motherfuckers around you start fasting.
There you go.
When you're in Mexico and fools are like, no, es que ahorita estoy haciendo un fast.
Mijo, ¿quieres comer?
No, es que estoy haciendo un fast como Dana White.
Yeah.
You know, like, sushi like
oh,
that.
Lord.
¿Cómo que no vas a comer? No, ma, es que la inflamación y que something else... Y las células de cáncer se mueren cuando no comes. ¿Cómo no vas a comer, cabrón?
Yeah.
Ándale, siéntate, ándale.
Yeah. Once you start seeing, like, food fasting in your area, call it quits.
Or carrying, like, a 1 gallon of water.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Just, like, just a powder, drinks all fucking day. Nah, dude.
Yeah. Would you think you got it in you to fast for 80-something hours?
86 hours,
86,
bro.
Yeah.
Dana White, he's what? Let me see.
How old is he? He's like
55, bro.
Yeah. Oh, you have it right here. Damn.
I feel incredible. And I want to tell you how I did it. I love sharing this kind of stuff with you. So when I left the event on Saturday night, I started fasting. And here's a picture of me Saturday night when I left. I just got done this morning. So Saturday.
This motherfucker's already fit, though.
And here are the pictures of me this morning.
Wow.
So I don't know if you've seen this online, but it's called the 7-day water fast. And this doctors have done studies on this, and this thing is legit. It gives you an over 70% chance.
All right, I don't even hear all that.
Yeah, that's too much jargon, science. But okay, Saturday night to Wednesday morning or something like that.
That's
it's about 3.5 days.
I did
something
the,
like that.
I did the 16-hour fast.
16?
For
that's,
2 weeks.
That's easy. That's easy.
I was losing my fucking mind.
Yeah?
Man. I was losing my... I was pacing back and forth. I was like... I wanted a fucking anything seasoned, bro. I wanted just to shove it down my fucking throat.
Yeah.
And it was just like... it was euphoric at a point.
Oh, fuck.
Like, I was fucking... hours. I was fucking on shrooms with no shrooms.
Were you drinking water, though?
Yeah. Okay. Well, I was drinking tons of water.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But and, you were going crazy.
Yeah, mm-hmm. dog. And then at work, fool, you couldn't even fucking look at me, dog.
Yeah, you're aggravated.
I was like, get the fuck out of here.
So 86 is out of the question.
Out of the question. Absolutely. That's insanity at that point.
Yeah?
I mean, you had to be a different type of animal for that. You know
or
what I mean?
Like a human or something?
You have to be like... Like, mentally, you got to be prepared for it.
Yeah,
for sure.
Mentally, yeah.
Because this whole eating every, like...
How often do you eat?
On a regular day?
Yeah, regular
a lot.
Day. How does it go? You wake up at...
Well, lately, I've been on my health. I'm gentrified right now.
Okay.
I'm gentrified as fuck. You know, sistema calibrado, configuraciones, rebalance, whatever. I go to the gym, and then I eat a smoothie. I drink a smoothie.
Oh, what's in the smoothie, though? Cause...
You really want to know? It's just a green juice. It's a green juice. Green smoothie.
Pineapple. It went from smoothie to green juice.
Okay. Pineapple, celery, fucking that shit. All the green and apple cider vinegar.
Okay.
And then after that, I just don't eat till lunchtime, 2 or 3.
Okay.
That's what I'm doing right now because your boy's getting was thickums.
And then dinner.
Or but
do you have a second lunch?
No. Dinner's crazy, bro.
You snack during the day?
No, I don't.
Twizzlers and shit?
No.
Don't lie.
No. Airheads. I try not to. And when I was like not giving a fuck, bro, when I was in ungentrified Franks, I was like chips, soda,
right?
Fucking candy, all that shit. But nah, you can't. I can't. My fucking knees were inflamed, bro.
Yeah,
they hurt.
Yeah, but not eating is out of the question.
Not eating at a point, I'll kill somebody.
I get you.
Yeah, and eat it.
So 16 hours is the most you've done.
Yeah, yeah. Because 80 hours is what am I for? What am I training for? To go to fucking Mars?
Yeah, you're training for gentrification.
What about that? That's the movement. I'm not going to eat because I'm a fucking protest.
When they come knocking at your door asking if you need a new Brita filter, you'll be like, hey, yeah, because I'm fasting right now. I'm on hour 79.
Yeah, mero.
And I need some reverse osmosis water.
Yeah, for alkaline. Oh, yeah, alkaline.
Yeah.
Alkaline.
I think I'm going to try it.
You're going to try it?
I'm going to try 24 hours because I've done 16 like nothing. I've done 18. I think the most I've done is 20.
Yeah.
But like a whole day without eating, I've never tried.
I need to either like fucking process some sort of
muscle. But see, okay, the way he did it, he had electrolytes and bone broth.
Ah.
The electrolytes have no calories, but the bone broth does. But the bone broth... doesn't really fuck up your... It doesn't break your fast. It'll just keep you like in ketosis.
Orale. Yeah, that ketosis shit is next
and
level.
And that shit will help you feel like not nauseous. You know how sometimes after you don't eat for a long time, you get nauseous? The electrolytes and the bone broth will help you kind of like coast. But it's still going to be in your head like a little KFC right now.
Fuck, bro. And that's the worst part, fool, because like you live in the most fast food accessible area ever.
That's the worst thing ever.
Yeah, dog. You can easily pass by a fucking Raising Cane's and get a whiff and just like, oh, la verga.
But you can keep going because in another mile, there's going to be another fried chicken spot.
Yeah.
And then with a McDonald's next
and
door.
And then a Shake Shack and then two in and outs in a row.
And then you got to stop at the liquor store and, for the brewskis.
Yeah, and then you go to Ojos Locos.
Yeah.
And then you get fucked up and you get a DUI on the way. On your 79th hour, you get a DUI. Because there's 7 bars on the way home.
So now you got to fast for another 24 hours because you're going to be in jail for a couple hours.
So the only way you could do an 80-hour fast is if you get a DUI.
Fuck. That's easy. That's lightweight. I'm sure right here there's a comment somewhere where somebody goes, oh, that's easy. But instead of an only water fast, I did an only beer fast.
Yeah.
Like start Friday night and I don't drink anything. I don't need anything until Monday morning. That's easy work.
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
That's crazy, bro.
It's crazy that fasting has been becoming more popular and it's more of a talk in the town. Like as soon as this fool posted this shit, everybody was talking about it. A lot of people were trying it and shit like that. And then there's a lot of people that are like, what the fuck? Like the Mexican moms are like, nah, you're going to eat.
Yeah. Te vas a desmayar.
But this shit goes way back. Like, fasting goes way back to, like, hunter-gatherer times. Where, like, you and the homies are trying to hunt.
Yeah.
But you haven't found shit for 3 days.
Yeah.
So then you finally catch something, you eat a whole cow.
Fuck yeah.
And then you fast again for, like, 3 days until you find another cow. And it's in the Bible. The Muslims do it during their Ramadan. Fasting is, like, a thing. Like, when you're, I think the Christian people, when they want to, like, really talk to God, they do a fast. And then they pray along the way, and then they fucking have revelations and shit like that.
What? I did not know this, bro. This is a fucking gentrified ass episode.
Yeah, because when you once you start feeding your body stuff, your body's like trying to survive. So your body stops thinking about bullshit and stops wasting energy on digesting bullshit that it's kind of like regenerating your cells from the inside out.
This is bullshit. This podcast is bullshit.
Yeah. We need a fast.
We need a fast.
We need to do a whole 1 hour episode where we just like.
Just don't say shit. Oh my God, bro. But it makes sense, fool. Like, it's just, I feel like toxins are in everything, right? So, like, you just gotta clean your asshole really good.
And don't shit for like 24 hours.
Yeah. You know también I mean? Eso, güey. Like, cagando is a thing, too. Like, you gotta shit, right? You can't be. I sent you a post one time. Well, this, if your shit looks like this, you're healthy.
Yeah,
your shit,
yeah.
And then what you say?
Because they had like seven types of shit on the table. There was like Play-Doh shit. Like,
yeah.
And it went from like healthy to unhealthy.
To right? Healthy to unhealthy. And then the unhealthy was like a pebbles and shit like that.
Yeah, the unhealthy was like a soft substance.
And you were like, what?
I was like, I've been to a level of shitting that they can't even show on that table. It's at least three spots to the left.
It's like water with a little spit.
Yeah, it's like water that's a little yellow. Have you ever shit that before? You know what I mean? Have you ever shit like at the end of the cereal milk? Have you ever shit like Fruity Pebble? Like soggy Fruity Pebble. The dark kind, the Choco Crispies. Have you ever shit soggy Choco Crispies?
Like a newborn.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yo, bro, now.
That shit that steams. That shit is so steamy that there's evaporation on your lower back. It looks like it's like you just showered in the restroom.
Yeah. Oh my God, bro. Let's get the fuck out of here. That was fucking funny. All right, guys. If you guys made it this far, you already know what it is. It's the Little Brown Boys podcast. Subscribe, like, leave a comment. Hope you guys learned a little bit about what's going on in Mexico. That shit was funny as fuck. Peace. Little brown boys.